Hey everyone, it's your buddy Graphic back with another video, and today we're just going to be showing you guys some PvP gameplay regarding the absolute insanity that takes place in some of these forts, whether it's Everfall, Windsward. If you guys want some PvP action, I do suggest taking your open world self to PvP in really these four areas, because as soon as you start contesting some of these forts, you are going to get some kind of response. Definitely with release coming, you're going to have so many players on every server, and they're going to be looking for this PvP action. So do expect if you, go into contest a fort, that there will be somebody there to, really bring that, bring that PvP to you. Like we see here, me with a billion other, syndicates running into this fort, tossing fireballs, running at them with great axe grab wells. They're not going to do anything besides die. And that's exactly what you're seeing here. As like I said, I'm going to be running Rapier, Fire Staff for a lot of this build. Realistically, I've talked about a Rapier Bow, Rapier Fire Staff. Those are the three weapons I'm going to focus on probably at release. I will try to level up everything and get really everything maxed at some point. Just, really trying to keep the content fresh for you guys. So keep that in mind. Right now, like I said, this is going to be one of the most fun open world for me, is just playing that Fire Staff and Rapier. I do want to jump into another clip now, focused on a little bit more for PvP. This time around, we are charging in, continuing to try to take out enemies on the fort that are contesting it. And this is something that's very, very fun. Obviously, we are outnumbering the enemies, but this is just kind of showing you guys where you can find PvP pretty much always. You can see this guy's kind of getting melted by, I got a ton of backstabs on him there as he continuously ran away instead of trying to fight. If he could have tried to fight there, he maybe had a chance just because I was split off in a 1v1. So always keep that in mind, guys. Keep your awareness. Understand that if it is a 1v1, take advantage of it. Try to get at least one kill before you die. There's no, no disappointing really play besides dying while you're running. If you get a kill, then die, it's not a big deal. Or if you at least die trying, that's another thing, because there is nothing for losing. You don't lose anything when you die, so keep that in mind. But you can see here, like I said, a pretty prolonged fight with some Covenant on top of the fort as well as on the sides of the fort, and just kind of chasing people around for a little bit here as well. As we can see, I jump out to the front, and there are two people, and I think they do try to fight me here. No, this guy actually tries to run to the gate, and that doesn't usually seem to work. This guy now does try to fight, so this is something I like to see out of people trying to at least, make a PvP fight happen. And like I said, guys, there's so much excitement regarding PvP, and that's exactly why I wanted to bring you guys these clips. People are just so, so excited, and if you want that PvP, like I said, in New World, running to a fort's going to find you a lot of open world PvP. Obviously, doing faction mission PvP quests are going to find you a lot as well, but you can see here how many people there were at some of these fort fights. Just so many, and just huge, large-scale PvP fights. So keep that in mind as well. If you're looking for more solo PvP fights, I would suggest PvP faction missions or just doing the main story. You're going to find people if you are flagged up. And also keep in mind, being flagged up gives you a 10% increase to XP, also giving you a chance for loot. So there's a lot of opportunities there. This guy is running around and continuing to heal. This is something that does take place quite a bit as well if you are trying to chase somebody down. I think eventually I do get him. Here we get a backstab slowing him down, that I get the auto with the fire staff, finishing him off and seeing that loot, like I said, that does drop pretty awesomely, with depending on how high of level the kills that you are getting, you can get actually, like I said, some great, great loot. There are some people still inside this fort fighting, and they just keep coming in, I'm assuming off spawn, or there's just more of them coming in. But you can see how fast they are getting just wiped by the massive amount of syndicate in this fort. I don't know what faction, by the way, I'm going quite yet, so keep that in mind. I did go syndicate during closed beta, and then I went covenant during open beta. So that's my current situation, and I think I am going to probably play Marauders during release, but we don't know what server, we don't know what faction exactly yet, so we'll keep you guys up to date with that as we get closer to launch. There's just so much excitement, like I said, surrounding PvP, because every weapon does seem to have its own special place. I did a PvP tier list with Cleo Menace, and it was a great PvP tier list in my opinion. I still have no regrets on that, thinking that everything kind of went where it needs to be. Life Staff being in such a solid, solid spot right now. You can see Ice Gauntlet, Great Axe, Warhammer, great spots right now. A great fight though, like I said, with Fire Staff and Rapier, you're able to just dive through everyone and just continually put out damage, and that's exactly what I love doing, obviously, is mobility, damage, open world PvP. So this is just another kind of quick, like I said, gameplay for you guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you guys have not already, make sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel. I am going to be starting to stream daily and definitely on release. So like I said, stay up to date with all of that on this channel. I'll see you guys all in the next one.